Hi, my name is Robin Dunne. I play Jimmy in the film Space Milkshake. I guess I could be best described as the...
Sexy
idiot.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, in real life at least.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, I'm typecast as a sexy idiot. It's a curse. It followed me around my entire career. You know, I read the script and I thought, this is probably the most ridiculous but funniest thing I've read. And it was definitely a departure for me. And I think a lot of the cast, I mean, I think you see the cast in different, the actors playing these parts, who are playing these parts in really different ways. And I just thought it would be a lot of fun, which it was. And also something that could just really, I really believe we've got a cult phenomenon on our hands. And I just want to take a shot and hopefully that comes true.
But I'm the captain. I play the captain of the ship, so you know.
Not the chief.
No, not the chief, the captain. Anton Balvenie is the character. And I just, when I read it as well, it just seemed different, you know. It just, you know, I'm always attracted to kind of different projects rather than kind of run of the mill, whether it's theatre or film or whatever. And I just thought, yeah, this looks really different. I'd worked with the producer before and I really liked it, you know. I thought, yeah, I think we could have a lot of fun with this. We're in space, in a sort of
metaphorical milkshake. Is that where
is it,
where you go?
Why
is
it? Why is it milkshake? I don't know. Is it?
Why are you putting me on the spot right now?
I mean,
he's the one supposed to ask the questions.
Right. You ask it. It's a metaphorical question.
It's a metaphor. I think the reason the film is called Space Milkshake is because I think people will go, why is this movie called Space Milkshake? I think that's basically, you know. It will pull people in. I think the one of the wonderful things about the movie is it's a farce. It's not making fun of the genre, but it's having a good time with the genre. And I think with this cast that we have, you know, Billy from obviously that little independent trilogy he did down in New Zealand. But you know, I think it's going to be a treat for the fans. Amanda Tapping, obviously the Stargate fans, they're going to see her in a different light. Kristen Kreuk.
She was Superman or something.
She was Wonder Woman. She was Wonder Woman. What she wasn't, but she should be.
She should be, exactly.
She's Wonder Woman in my dreams. but you know, and then the Sanctuary fan, that's coming out to watch me. I think it's a real treat. And then obviously we're forgetting about George Takei or Takei. There's an argument as to what's right, but you know. George Takei's voice is very prominent in the film, so that's got the Star Trek fans. So I think it's a real treat for the fans of all these genres to see these actors in ways that you haven't seen them before.
And as Robin says, we're not, you know, in any way taking the mickey out of the genre, because, you know, speaking for myself, I love the genre. I love space movies. I love, you know, it's probably my favourite. So to be able to be up there kind of, I was saying that as if I actually was in space. Mm-hmm. I wasn't. I was in Saskatchewan.
Yeah, which is kind of like space. It's kind of like...
But, you know, to be there on this set and kind of like, you know, be part of this kind of space movie was just brilliant, you know. I loved it. Yeah.
The way the film was made and shot and the approach to the film, I mean, definitely it's a comedy, but the way... the way we approached it was to play everything really straight. So, you know, you're gonna get the feeling of Alien. You're gonna get the feeling of 2001. Even with the score, the way we approached the score was playing it really like a traditional sci-fi movie score. So therefore, when you have all these really very real elements to the traditional, playing homage to these, iconic sci-fi movies, but then you also have, you know, Billy being chased by a giant morphed rubber duck. It just makes the absurdity pop that much more, and I think it's going to be great for the fans.
And I think a lot of the comedy came from thinking, okay, this is a space station and it's been there for years, and the best space movies are the ones where you can see the rust, you know, you can see that it's old. So we said, well, let's take this the next step. What happens when things start breaking down and, you know, there's no one there to fix it, and we're just real people in space, so it's kind of, you know, pushing that envelope. So rather than, You know, it's so it is kind of playing it for real, but just how far can you push that reality, you know?
Also, I mean, today's event's all about sort of the fans. Have you guys had any weird fan experiences? I mean, Billy, especially with Lord of the Rings, you must have had people come up to you dressed as hobbits, that kind of thing?
Yeah, there's been a few. There's one girl who lives in my house now, and a little hobbit. No, it's not. No, obviously there is, you know, there's, you know, things that, you know, that push that reality. You know, when people come up and they've got a, you know, a tattoo of your face or something, and that kind
I
of thing. Kind of
I have a he's talking about me, because I have a tattoo of Billy's face.
How you guys met?
Yeah. He said,
actually,
look
not.
At this.
I'll show it to you right now.
He's
I'll
lying, because it's on his ass. Yeah. It's not there.
It's actually in between my ass and my the whole.
Oh,
the,
no, never yeah. Mind.
I know. Yeah. And I can make him say I can make him say wow. You want Billy to say wow?
Don't say no.
I think we'll leave it. Yeah,
let's go. Yes.
Space Milkshake.
Say Space Milkshake. Check it out.